it's frantic. I mean, the start line is as busy as any Big One design fleet you'll see.
This fleet is really close. Places change at every mark rounding.
There's more boats here than there are at the TP52s.
We're here to learn and we're going to give them a fight later on. We're not there yet. It was very fun though.
When 12 closely matched Grand Prix boats are racing for a prestigious and ornate trophy that dates back to 1899, it's inevitable that the competition will be tight. But even by the standards set in the Fast 40-plus class, this year's HYS One-Ton Cup took the fleet onto another level. There were no runaway leaders, and several had a taste of the front end of the fleet. Peter Morton's Girls on Film, Stuart Whitehead's Rebellion, Steve Cowie's Zephyr, Tony Dickens' Jubilee, Bastavug's Hitchhiker, and Heinz-Peter Schmidt's Silver Neo all had podium finishes on the first day's racing. But as the regatta played out, a pecking order developed with Morton's Girls on Film taking a lead. A second consecutive one-ton victory looked likely for the Cowes-based team. Until, that is, the penultimate race of the event. Morton's team jumped the gun and had to restart, placing them at the back of the fleet. Hauling their way back to fourth and discarding their sixth place in the final race was sufficient to maintain their overall lead. The message was clear. The Fast 40 Plus is a hot fleet and getting hotter. So what makes these 40-foot carbon rockets tick? The World Sailing Show went aboard to find out.
My name's Anthony Haynes. I'm boat captain and part of the crew of Pace, which is this boat. We sail the boat with 11 crew, and sort of going from the back, you'll have more the navigator roles and the tactician. Here you have various controls here. This is the pedestal, which obviously controls the winches, which are engaged through these buttons, which lead under deck to various drive shafts and gearboxes that link forward. So the buttons obviously engage and disengage the winches. And when you tack, you obviously tack or jibe, you change to the other side. Then you have a helmsman who'll be sort of obviously more square to the tiller here. He'll be in this area and generally will spend most of his time sort of sitting, you know, sitting here with the foot bars to keep his back out to the guard wire. So he'll be sat sort of out here with the adjustable tiller extension steering the boat. In this area, this is sort of middle of the boat, so it's the main sort of hub where all the sort of sail handling work is coordinated from. This area here is what we call the pit. We hoist quite a lot of our sails using these winches because they're a lot more powerful, bigger, and they're driven by the pedestal. So typically, and then we can cross lead a halyard typically to a left side winch like that. So then we have versatility to use either winch. So here at the mast, you can see that there are only two halyards coming out of the mast, spinnaker halyard and a jib halyard. There'll be no other controls. Everything else is led down below deck to keep the deck free. This is what we call our forehatch. Fundamentally, we use this for getting sails up and down from below. Here we have the spinnakers. These are our two that we used yesterday, so different codes on them, illustrating what wind they should be used in and thus different shapes. So this would be our A4. This would be the heavy wind spinnaker or the heaviest spinnaker we carry on board. And this is our A2+. This is, obviously this is the mast coming down through the deck opening. From there you can see where the mast is situated, and underneath here, this whole structure is basically the sort of load area of the boat. Okay, so here we are more towards the middle of the boat. This is just the house switches, which turns on the instruments, bilge pumps, deck screens, etc. These are the battery switches, and interestingly, batteries, now we run with these very lightweight lithium ion batteries. This saves a huge amount of weight, and you see we have three green top house batteries, we call them. They run the boat systems. Then we have this one orange battery here, which is purely allocated for starting the engine. The boats are a challenge. On windy days like today, it's fairly challenging, but they are a lot of fun and very rewarding when you get it right.